I've been thinking about a sermon my husband does. It's about the linen girdle. And in thinking about that, I thought of the term, gird up your mind. 1 Peter 1:13 says, "Wherefore, gird up the loins of your mind, be sober, and hope to the end for the grace that is to be brought unto you at the revelation of Jesus Christ." When my husband preaches this sermon about the linen girdle, he explains that when in Bible days, men and women wore long flowing garments, and they wore a group of material around their midsection so that when they're working or doing something, they would gird it up. They would reach through their legs, pull the back of the long garment and pull it up through, and then tuck it in this piece of material around their waist. And that meant girding up your loins. I think we could compare it to the terminology we use today of rolling up your sleeves. I mean, you're getting ready to do something, and it's going to be a hot job, so you roll up your sleeves and dig in. Or when I'm getting ready to do the dishes, if I'm going to put my hands in water and I got long sleeves on, I roll up my sleeves first. So girding up your mind is preparing for something, and it's getting you ready for it. Well, in my mind, every single day of my life, I have to gird up my mind. I have to concentrate on the right things. My mind just naturally wanders to negatives. You know, my mind wanders to, like, it's very warm right now. So the natural tendency is to just go around talking about how hot it is, you know. And to be honest with you, that doesn't change the weather. You know, to talk about how hot it is, it doesn't change the weather. It just brings it to our mind. I'm living in a motorhome, and that motorhome can't keep up with heat outside, so we have fans sitting everywhere trying to keep the air moving. Can I tell you this? My mind, when I start to think how warm it is, my mind thinks, boy, praise the Lord, I got a fan that can help keep the air moving and keep it cool, a little, you know, more bearable to be in here. That's girding up my mind. When I'm frustrated, sometimes I start feeling sorry for myself because we have to travel this long distance. Can I tell you that? It's the truth. Today I'm leaving in about 45 minutes to travel to Peoria, Illinois to see my tax man about something. And do I want to make this 7-hour trip today? No. But my mind wants to complain about it and talk about it. But what I should be thinking is, boy, isn't it great that I got a tax man that can help me with this? Isn't it great that I'm only 2.5 hours away from him instead of 10 hours away from him? You know, that's girding up my mind. And being thankful that God made a way for me to get the problem taken care of, and this tax man's going to do it for me. Do you understand? Don't let your mind wander and stay on the negative. Gird up your mind. Be sober and hope to the end for the grace that is to be brought unto you at the revelation of Jesus Christ. Yep, let's all be people that think on things on purpose. Rejoice in the Lord always, and again I say rejoice.